What's good, y'all? Rich Sosa back in the building with another banger. And before we get into anything else, man, I just gotta say all grace goes to God. Thank y'all as well as him for having me in your life as well as me and you connecting on this fine day, man. I got a very fire, super rare, first ever points center build, y'all. This build is going to be able to break ankles, and it's actually going to be able to speed boost and be usable as well, y'all. So again, there's going to be multiple ways to break it down to y'all, but the way that I'm bringing it today is going to be very unique, and you are most definitely going to be able to also get that rim protecting takeover. So before we get into anything else, man, thank y'all for coming through. But man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody looking to join RGF, the Rich Gang family, man, go ahead and turn on post notifications. But also, do not forget to hit that like button since y'all are already here. Can we go ahead and get 100 likes on this banger? Super rare build in store for y'all. And most definitely, this is going to be one of the funnest rare builds to use, especially when it comes down to the build name. So, this build is made out of the center position, of course. Now, when it comes down to the jersey number, go ahead and put number one because this is the first of its kind. So, when it comes down to the pie chart that y'all want to go ahead and pick, of course, if you thought this, you thought right, we're going to go ahead and pick the full playmaking pie chart, y'all. I'm telling you, this one is definitely going to be worthy of using when it comes down to any type of position, whether it be the center, power forward, and more so especially the point guards. Now, when it comes down to the physical profile, I know a lot of y'all like to go ahead and pick the very first one for the fastest speed, but if you pick the one right here, the fourth one, you get a huge boost to the vertical. Again, this is a point center, so we're actually going to go ahead and just end up picking the very first physical profile because of the speed. But these physicals are going to get a huge boost once we adjust the height on this build. So again, do not worry. Now, when it comes down to the breakdown of these stats, just be sure that y'all follow along because there's going to be a lot of different things that you have to take into consideration when it comes down to making this build, because any single change, you're at risk of changing up the build name. So let's go ahead and get right into it. When it comes down to the shooting, max out the mid-range, three-pointer, free throw, and put that post fade to a 68. 12 badges right there for the shooting side of things. Now, let's go ahead and get into the pass accuracy. First, we have to go ahead and put this to a 72. Of course, you want to max out that ball handle, and then the post control, put this to a 94. If you end up getting 29 or 30 badges for the playmaking side of things, the build name is going to change to a playmaking 5. Now, let's go ahead and get into the defense. Interior, 71. Perimeter defense, 49. Lateral quickness, same exact thing. Skip over the steal for now. Max out that block. Offensive rebound, 71. And the defensive rebound is going to be an 82. And we get 11 defensive badges on this build. Now, we're going to be able to actually get park dunks on this build. Max out your driving dunk and then put the rest into the driving layup. These numbers are all going to change once we go ahead and take a look at the height. So be sure just to know that when it comes down to the body shape, I know, like I always say, the biggest body shape is burly, which takes up the most space. But for this one, honestly, I'm going to go with compact just to go with the build name a little bit more. Now, here's where things get crazy. Go down to 6'9", y'all. You're going to be able to speed boost in takeover with this build. You're still going to be able to get the rim protecting takeover. And look at that driving dunk being a 68. Once you get to 97 overall right here as is, you will be able to get the park dunks that we want at 70. Now, you can make any changes to this, but I'm telling y'all, the build name is subjected to change. When it comes down to the weight, we want to be the fastest possible. So, go ahead and put the weight to 193. It's not going to affect anything except one tick off of the vertical. Again, you can go ahead and just go with the lowest if you want to. But for me, I still want to be able to make this build as heavy as possible without losing anything to my speed or acceleration. And I feel like that's going to be perfect right here, y'all. So as for the wingspan, you have two or actually a couple different options to go with. The max being 88.0, or you could go with 82.0, y'all. Both of these are going to be fine, anything in between as well. But if you end up going out of the range, the build name is going to change, y'all. So again, I would highly recommend just going with the max possible wingspan at 88.0. Just because we want to go ahead and get much better contest on the defensive end. But if you want a higher three ball, I would say just go ahead and lower it. But again, remember, you're going to have takeover, boost, running with a teammate that is going to have the floor general, y'all, which is going to give you a boost as well. Then you have dimer, post playmaker as well as special delivery. You should not be missing with this build. So when it comes down to the physicals, at 99 overall, we will be getting an 80 speed. Vertical is going to be in the 70s. Then right here off rip, we will be able to unlock the park dunks. But at 99 overall, you get a 75 driving dunk, which is going to be clutch. Then when it comes down to that mid-range, also, this has the potential to hit the 80s. Then the three-pointer also has the potential to be in the mid-70s. Remember, grinding this build out to 99, which is a plus 4. Bind boost, and then the teammate with floor general, 12 in total. So this build is actually really nice when it comes to even the rec. As you can see, the free throw, definitely going to be a huge factor. But then on the playmaking, with the takeover that you pick, you will be able to speed boost, y'all. But then from there, if you add boost and everything else that goes into it, you're going to have around an 83 ball handle, y'all, once this build is maxed out completely. Now, for the defense, interior and the perimeter are actually both going to be able to go in the 70s. Same exact thing for the lateral quickness. Block will be in the 80s. Offensive rebound and the defensive are both going to go from 70 to 80 and 80 to 90, y'all. But look at these takeovers that we get. We're going to be able to get the rim protecting, glass cleaning, very overpowered and toxic for the defensive end. Then we also get the post scoring as well as the playmaking to dime up our teammates as well as break ankles, y'all. So again, whichever takeover y'all pick, going to be fine. But I'm going to go with the playmaking for the build name. And as y'all can see, we have made the most rare first ever point center build on NBA 2K22 current gen, y'all. I'm telling you, this build is definitely going to be game changing, especially with what it's going to be able to do. Now remember, everything has to be taken into consideration. Bind boost, which is plus 4. Then also grinding the build out to 99, another plus 4. And then if you're running with a teammate that has floor general, another plus 4, which equals 12 in total. Now, when it comes down to the finishing side of things, you have a couple different options to go with here, but I would go with Posterizer or Fearless Finisher just to get those layup animations unlocked. Now, let's go ahead and get into the shooting. 12 badges that we're going to be able to work with. Honestly, that's fine with me. I'm going to go with Hot Zone Hunter, Corner Specialist, as well as Catch and Shoot all on gold. Now, with the last three, here is where I'm actually going to spread the wealth, going with Bronze, Green Machine, Deadeye, as well as Volume Shooter. Now remember, you can change any of the bat setups as you like based on your preference, but I'm telling y'all, this is easily going to be the best way to go about it. Now, when it comes down to the defense, 11 badges to work with. So right here, I'm going to go with Gold Intimidator. Also, you cannot forget about Rebound Chaser. I'm going to go ahead and put that on Silver. Rim Protector, I really like it on Gold, and then go with Bronze Chase Down Artist. With these next two badges, I would go ahead and put them on Clamps, but again, remember, if you feel like changing anything about this build, you definitely can do so, but it's just based off of how you feel like using it. For me, another way to go about it is adding Interceptor. Then you could even change up Rim Protector as well as the Intimidator badge. Both of these are going to be super solid, but as long as you have these badges on, I truly believe that everything is going to work out in your favor. I'm going to go with the three gold badges right here when it comes down to the defensive end. That's more my style. And now, let's go ahead and get into the playmaking, y'all. A lot of wealth when it comes down to this category. So, I'm going to go with first, Handles for Days on Hall of Fame, as well as Quick First Step. Now, also, you might as well as throw on Triple Threat Juke. Also, go ahead and put on Floor General, because this build is definitely going to be able to be used in any game mode, and you're also going to be able to run with your teammates and have success with the badge count that we got. Now, I'm going to go with Hyperdrive as well. Definitely going to help us out, especially when we can speed boost and takeover. Then I'm going to go with Bronze Bailout as well as Silver Unpluckable. Now, we got five more badges to work with. Another one that I'm going to consider, of course, you cannot forget about Bullet Pastor. And the very last one I'm going to go with is going to be Special Delivery. And this is the setup we're going with. 11 defensive, then we get 28 playmaking, 12 shooting, and 1 finishing. Again, thank you, God, for giving me this opportunity just to be a part of everybody's lives who is watching. Thank you for having them in mind as well. I just want y'all to know that I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. I send y'all my blessings as much as I possibly can, y'all. I just need y'all to know I appreciate y'all, and none of your efforts go unnoticed. I really see y'all in the comment section. I got more bangers dropping next week. This wraps it up for the double uploads this weekend. But man, best believe we are going to go ahead and get back to the daily uploads throughout the week as well. So do not worry. But man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody who wants to join RGF, the Rich Gang family, and all are welcome to, go ahead and turn on post notifications, but also go ahead and hit that like button. Let's get 100 likes on this video. Be sure to go ahead and share it with your family and friends. And man, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Thank God, and Rich out.